Yo, quick question before I get this started. Am I under Prof's account or Stophouse's account? Whose account is this? I'm using a iPad. I don't fuck with iPads, you know what I mean? What's up, UK? Whose account is this? Is this mine? Alright, good. Finally, some. Tell me what the fuck's poppin'. Cool, this is a beat I made. I don't know if y'all heard it already, but it's fucking ill. What's up, Scotchy? Hey! Scotchy's my best friend, y'all. Go follow Scotchy, he's my best friend, y'all. Today's gonna be cool. I was thinking about having a special guest today, and then I was like, no. Because, when I have special guests, I end up talking to them the whole time. So I'm thinking this time at 3:30, I'm gonna end the lesson at 3:30, and I'm gonna go straight over to taking calls. You know what I'm saying? You can come up with my chat. You know what I mean? And I'll have more time critiquing other people's music and shit like that. Cause I haven't really done that in the past couple weeks. We hadn't have a lot of time for that. Today is going to be interesting. Today I'm going to go over how a good song is like good sex, or a bad song is like bad sex. You know what I mean? But they're very, very similar. Sex is, music and art is communication, and good sex is good communication too. If everybody's on the same page, it's probably the best thing in the world. Sex, I don't know, maybe music too. I don't know, both. They're just so fucking similar. You know what I mean? Yeah, so I think I'm gonna dive into it. This beat here, if this was a piece of sex, this would be the start. This would be the smaller foreplay or something like that. You know what I mean? It's very broadly, sex and songs both have to start. This might be penetration right here. Oh, now we fuck it. Okay, yay, hey, yay, wow. Okay. So there's intros. There's choruses. You work up, you speed it up, you slow it down. There's choruses. There's verses. There's bridges. You know, like switching up a position would be like a bridge or something like that. You know what I mean? And let's say you get some people who have fucked before and they want to do some 50 Shades Grey shit, you know what I mean? And they're like, let's just fucking hit them right away, you know? They know each other, they know what to expect. Some songs jump in just like fucking crazy. You can't even get your feet wet. I'm gonna do a little, this fucking iPad is so big. I'm gonna do a little, question for y'all. You can answer through your tippity-typity texties. What do you think is like the most sexual artist of all time? You know, you got like Lil' Kim and shit. Usually through rap, when it comes to rap and just the stereotypes and shit, especially back in the day, the most sexual rappers were the women, because that's how they flaunted their shit. And I'm not going to get into why. It's getting different now. Women can be a little bit more well-rounded and shit, but you think Prince, okay, yep. Lil' Kim, just super sexy, Too Short. Big Daddy Kane, Al Green, Enya, okay. Doja Cat, no doubt. I like that. Foxy Brown, yeah, Foxy Brown was fucking wild. Yeah, so I'm gonna play a song for you. You might think the most X-rated song of all time would be from maybe one of them. It's not. Most X-rated song of all time goes to Ella Fitzgerald. You heard me? Ella Fitzgerald wrote some of the sexiest motherfucking songs of all time. And this song I'm about to play you, albeit, you know, it's a very positive mood and everything, but oh my God, it's sexy. It's X-rated. X-rated nudity. The sexiest song I've ever fucking heard in my life. Listen to her walk through the fucking door in her goddamn skimpies. Oh shit, she's dripping sex appeal. Now she's laying down in bed. Creeping down in the bed. I'm way down in bed getting seduced by Ella Fitzgerald. She's coming in the bed. We're necking. Here we go. Oh, we fucking, baby. We cook it with grease. We cook it with grease. Oh, she's wild. Goosebumps. Here we go. Oh shit, I'm about to come. Ooh. It's a simultaneous orgasm. Lights of fucking cigarettes. What the fuck? Lean back, baby. Thank you. Sex. It was great. Good night, motherfucker. Good night. Oh. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh my God. Can I show you a good goddamn song? Can I show you a goddamn song?
Sure, you can show me a song. If you're fucking lucky enough, bitch, at fucking 3:30.
So that song was, to me, one of the sexiest songs of all time. And I consider myself like a big Ella Fitzgerald fan. And I didn't even, I heard that for the first time this morning. It's called, what is it called? Like Smooth Sailing. Yeah, Smooth Sailing. And I'm ashamed that I haven't. I mean, I probably heard that before sometime in my life, but I was like, this is on Prof Creative Academy. Aloha, what's up, man? Where y'all tuning in from? It's hard for me to hear all songs at all times, you know what I mean? And especially, I listen to a lot of contemporary rap because it's my motherfucking, like, it's my job, you know what I mean? But it's hard. It's even my favorites. Some songs I'm not aware of, even that are fucking, I don't know how famous that is. I'm gonna dig into it later. But obviously, you have the seduction right away. Boop, boop. Boop, boop. She's... Boop, 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 boop. Okay,
okay, so that's her walking through the door as sultry as fucking possible. You know, I imagine that in some goddamn lingerie or something like that. And she's walking around, you know what I mean? So everybody's just, it's communication. They're giving their offering. It goes in and out. You have your highs, your lows. And most songs will work your way up to a climax, to an orgasm. Hopefully your sex does too. So that song is sexy as fuck. A lot of songs don't have climaxes like that. It's still chill. Maybe the chorus is the climax and you have multiple orgasms. It's up to you. Another thing I wanted to talk about today was how your voice is an instrument, because in the past few episodes of Prof's Creative Academy, when I tell people, when I try and give them critique, it's something that comes up over and over and over again. My biggest critique to people is, I find out, is the same. And then we're going to go over how your voice is an instrument. And then we're going to go to, if I got time before 3:30, I'll show you a Pro Tools session and a beat I made and how I like to switch it up and how I use layers of the song and take out layers and put in layers to help me through the writing process. If that makes any sense. It's pretty detailed and it might be kind of boring to y'all, but you'll definitely learn you something. So as far as voice as an instrument, we have some little Papa's apple juice. Almost all the people I hear, and I guarantee you I'll say the same critique today when I listen to people's songs, is they don't sound right. You know what I'm saying? Your voice is a fucking instrument, right? And you don't expect someone to, and they're brand new to music, right? And they just feel, since they know how to talk, they should know how to fucking rap or sing or something like that. You know, it's like, and you don't expect it, like a guitar player to come in there and be like, you know, oh, I'm new to this. Like, ding, ding. No, it takes a long, long time to learn what you want to say, but even more so how you want to say it. And that was a really good example. Ella Fitzgerald. Motherfucker, she knew, she was a grown-ass woman in that song. She knew exactly how to say it. And she wasn't saying shit. She didn't say one fucking word that whole song. That's another point that I wanted to make today. People get ahead of themselves when they're trying to be rappers or singers, and they're writing down lyrics and shit, and they don't even know how to play their instrument. They don't even know how to play, like, their trombone or whatever. And so what I want to tell people, I'm like, you have to learn your voice, learn, just scat your way through a fucking song and understand, are you subject to talking a certain way? Do you have a lower voice? Do you use a certain something as a crutch? You know, just go through a couple songs. And use your voice, use melody, rhythm, just chop, nonsense, scat. It's called scatting here. A couple of weeks ago, I was showing you how I write songs about raps. And I'll do passes through songs that sound just like that. It's not as jazzy. It's more contemporary hip hop, like triplets. You know, it's a different melody, rhythms and shit like that. But it's the same thing about what Ella was doing there. I hope she got really good writer's credit for that without saying a fucking word. That song's fucking incredible. She didn't say a word. Okay? You could listen to the whole thing and have that fucking feeling. So before people, it's really, really important to write good lyrics. Good lyrics are, it's paramount, right? But before that, you need to be able to just know how to rap or how to sound or just how to use your instrument. You know what I mean? So a lot of times I'm like, I hear someone I don't believe you're Ebonics or something. You're putting on an act, you know, you ain't a hood dude. So, or you just need to be aware of who you are before you, and do some self-reflecting before you just decide to be a fucking
musician. You know what I mean? So I don't know if this is a. Are you a street dude? You know what I'm saying? Is that how you're gonna rap? You know what I mean? Or are you not a street dude? Because right now rap is so broad that you could be whoever you want, however you want. You know what I mean? You don't need to be fucking tough guy hood dude all the time. I'm gonna play some music in the background. What are the characteristics of your voice? How are you gonna use them? You know what I mean? I think Young Thug knows how to use his fucking instrument. He's actually a good jazz singer. I said that earlier. I think him and Ella Fitzgerald would be able to make an incredible fucking song together. That's right. Young Thug, Ella Fitzgerald combo. Prof never lies to you. I always tell you the truth. Let me fix this little camera. Huh. So in a little over 10 minutes, I'm going to take calls from people. I'm going to listen to their music. All right, so please don't play music off of a computer. It's already fucked up enough for me to try and listen to it through Instagram because, you know, it's awful, even through speakers, through Instagram. If it's through Instagram and through a computer, what's up, Romania? Then it just sounds fucking shitty. All right, so if you want to play me your music, be sitting at speakers, be ready to play your music, and then play a chorus and a verse, or a verse and a chorus. That's it. Ain't nobody got time to fucking listen to a 3-4 minute long song. We're only gonna listen to maybe an hour. I mean a minute tops. I ain't listen to an hour of a song anyways. All right, so I do got time right now. Use your instrument, bitch. And Ella Fitzgerald. Oh yeah. Let's listen back to how Ella was using her instrument. Really quick. Listen to how she was using her instrument, man. So at first it comes out, she's communicating pretty easy to take in. Very easy to take in, as opposed to later when she's having some kind of fucking, you know, climax. Like you don't just start with that shit. You're like, wow, you know. Yo, what a technical fucking passage. Oh my god, what a fucking great. Man, I don't know. Maybe I don't. I'm not a fucking genius, and I don't know everything about music, but I think Ella Fitzgerald could be the best jazz singer of all time. Listen to this fucking passage. How to use your fucking instrument? Okay, so I skipped right over the intro. How she's soothing you in, you know, she's welcoming you in and shit like that. Listen to how technical and how, but at the same time technical, but at the same time just free spirit, orgasm, high energy, incredible passage. Just listen to this one more time. Okay, and then obviously it comes in with this big chorus of singers, and they're all on the same page with a huge, strong message. Boop, boop, doo-ah, motherfucker. You know what I mean? Absolutely incredible. And then she starts grunting at one point. What is she grunting? I need to hear. She go, goosebumps. Use your fucking instrument. Holy shit. Perfect example. Use your fucking instrument. That is that. Yes, that's a bop, y'all. That fucking slaps. No shit. Ella Fitzgerald is a goddamn thug. You know, you might hear some, you know, songs with her and Louis Armstrong, and she's just kind of like that pleasant voice or whatever. But this motherfucker wails. Don't you ever forget it. Louis Armstrong wails too. Maybe I'll share a Spotify playlist. It's like 150 songs of music like this that I listen to in the morning that is best music of all time, world class. Young Thug as fuck, exactly. Should I get into this? Okay, so I want to get into how I write and what it's this is a tangent. I was thinking I might spend more time on Ella, and I probably could. Ella, you like my lamp? You like my fucking lamp? I shouldn't be reading comments because it's too fucking random. All right, so I think I'm going to grab this iPad and I'm going to switch it around to this beat I made and give you guys an inside look on what Pro Tools looks like and what this beat looks like. I'm pretty sure I'm going to turn this beat into a song that you're probably going to hear a year and a half. Super behind on releasing music. P.S. What is the fucking day today? It's April 21st. In less than 10 days, something's going to happen. So in less than 10 days, something ground fucking shifting, groundbreaking is going to happen. We're in class, bro. Join us. Okay. Damn, well, Mac, I just said I was going to look at this beat. I'm gonna look at this beat real quick first, Mac. And I think maybe next week I'll get into a real nerdy session and get into details about Pro Tools and what things are called. What Pro Tools is basically the industry standard. Let me flip it around. Pro Tools is basically the industry standard ass fucking shit ass shit. Every single color that runs across the screen, this is a timeline, okay? Every single color that runs across the screen is a different instrument. Okay, so let's see what the fuck this is. Looks like a snare. Looks, it's a fucking kick. So that instrument only happens every few seconds. So let's tie it into another kick. No, that's a snare. Okay, listen how those instruments play off each other. It's like, what the fuck is it, right? Let me add in another kick, see if it starts to turn to music. What? This is interesting, right? What the fuck is this, right? So every single one of these is another layer. So I'm gonna start adding layers as I go. Okay, so that's like a main snap here. Here's some Rhodes I played. So I'm going over here and soloing these instruments. So as you go through, it's hard for me. I take so much shit for granted. I'm trying to keep it as basic and simple as possible. This might seem very elementary to people. This might be completely new to people. So I just have to start at the bottom, if I can. So there's a million. This is a ding ding. You hear that? That's one instrument. I was like, oh, I just gotta go ding ding every once in a while. So that's a happy little snare right there. So there's a little groove maybe that you could freestyle to. If you're talking about me, then I'm talking about you, True Blue. You know, talking about my crew. Okay, so you can freestyle this, right? All right, now let's see this percussion here. That makes it pop a little bit. That's not my offbeat. You know what I mean? That percussion. A shaker.
Here's more percussion. Another fucking shaker. A bongo. All right, now this is getting to something, right? Like, oh shit. Now these are the two biggest instruments. Will be the bass and the main melody coming up soon here. There it is. All these instruments playing at the same time. This right here is going to be a break. That main instrument falls out. That shaker falls out. So what happens right here when this shaker falls out, let me make this, you can take these and drag them down, make them bigger. This is the shaker. When the shaker sets a mood, right? Man, I'm holding this big ass iPad and I can't do my quick command keys. God damn. listen to when this falls out, the chicka 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 makes a huge difference and it puts you in a whole new space. Now it's clean. The whole space is clean. It's open for a verse. So what I like to do, that would be a chorus. And then right now, this makes a lot of space for my voice. You know what I mean? Bring the motherfucker in now. That's how I end my verse. So I played this a couple weeks in a row and I haven't done any work to it because I've been busy doing some other shit, so fuck you. Alright, I'm gonna start taking calls now. Call number five. So what this is called is a breakout. So if a producer sends a rapper a beat, and it's just one song and it's just one beat and it's like an MP3 or some shit or maybe even a wave, but you don't have control over all these different instruments, then that's lame. You know, then that's pretty lame. Not only do you want to be able to mix once you put your vocals in, they take up an area of frequency that might compete with different instruments in here. So you want to be able to pull instruments out, mix. So the mix can be completely different too. And you want to be able to take instruments out when you're getting when you're losing inspiration, right? So if you listen to this whole thing all. I made this break right here in the beat that's nowhere else because I like to write the different feeling, a different feeling. So this is a different break right here. So all the drums are out. It's like a bass. Now that gives me a different feel and gives me a different inspiration and something to write to. Bring it back. You know what I'm saying? So that's that. Maybe next week I'll go really far in depth into that shit. It's a little bit harder to carry an iPad like this, but I'm gonna bring in some motherfucking callers. Caller number fucking five. Here we go. All right. I'm gonna take the first one. I don't see you, Max. I'm gonna take the first one. AB Shields. Let's hear. Let's see what this dude's up to. Adam Garcia, what's up?
Oh shit, it's me. Hey, what up, bro? I was playing to your little joint. Hold on, how you doing?
Let me turn the speakers up in this bitch. All right.
Cool. I'll be the same.
What's your name? Where are you from?
Yo, I'm from Cincinnati, Ohio. Shout out to Mr. fucking Dibs and Mr. High Tech. You know those fuckers.
Yes,
for sure. But I go by BCS. I was going to play you a hook and a little verse and then call it a day. All
right.
But I also had a question after that, if that's all right.
Yeah, let's do it, man. I got a half hour to go through people's shit, get drunk, and just hang out.
Hell yeah. Got my cup, too.
You got some powerful, fuck, you got powerful hair, man.
Thank you.
And I don't think you're even bald. That's just how you...
I just shaved it yesterday. I had a mohawk.
Oh shit.
Yeah. I hear just being reckless like fucking Dibs does, you know. All right, cool. I'll play you a hook and then a little verse. Go from there.
Bet.
All right, all right. I did also my song. As soon as we locked our heads off, after that first kiss, I had enough. When we said goodbye, I had enough. The last time we met, I had enough. Sweetie, sugar, cutie, wifey, weenie, baby, boo. I don't know how I could ever find the word for you other than perfect, because that I think about is the feeling that you give me from my head to my shoes. Without a glass, the last thing that I ever want to do was ruin this relationship with you. But it was bound to happen. With my lifestyle, the last thing that I ever want to do was say goodbye to us now. You wanted to move on, and meanwhile, you get the point. I was going to be gone for a while, and to leave you hanging, that's not really my style. But if there was ever an opportunity to rekindle that fire, I'd like to strike the first match. Remember, I owe you a couple of drinks, and if you ever needed me, I'd be back in a flash. Could you allow me this last chance to rehash? Because you honestly would hell of a catch.
There it is.
Okay, so, like I said, I don't know if you're listening to my whole podcast, whatever the fuck this is. I was like, the number one critique I give people is like their instrument. Yeah, so like your writing is decent, but your instrument, there's times where you're like, and then me too, and then your breaths are not,
mm-hmm.
You know, it's just you don't seem that good yet, and you know, you might be new to it or whatever, and you don't for know sure. exactly how to use your instrument yet. But did you break out into a live?
Yeah.
Okay. I love that. So you filled that 4 bars, that 8 bar.
Yeah, just fucking around here.
How close are you to your computer? Your speakers? Move around.
Real close.
Real close?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so I think that's too close because I couldn't hear shit that well. So people who are coming in and tuning in, we're all learning this together. Try not to
for
have
sure.
your shit too close because it was. I barely heard shit. This is, I'm just taking a guess. You know what I mean? But
for sure.
I think it could have been too loud. But props. I would say you're musically very talented. Did you make the beat too?
Yeah, did most of, I'll be like 90% of it. And my friend Ilpo, I don't know if you know Il Poetic, but he helped me out with that too.
Yeah, I heard of him.
Yeah.
All right, yeah.
But I do have one question though for you, if you're willing to answer.
What's up?
On Andre the Giant, at the very, very end of your track, you say, Cuckoo, Cuckoo. I was wondering, is that a Mexican reference to Cuckoo Paloma?
No.
All right. Beautiful song. You should check that song out.
Okay. Shit. Yeah. A lot of people get like double meanings to my shit, and I don't know. Like I just sometimes I just do shit, and that's a point to be made that like there's rarely an original idea. You know what I mean? Anymore. Even if for me that was just me being like and you're like, yeah, someone else already did that. Yeah, someone else already did like everything. So that's a
for sure
point. All right, man. Take it easy down in Cincy, dog.
All right, bro. Peace.
Thanks for tuning in.
Yeah, bro.
All right, then. I think don't play your phone too close to the speakers because it overwhelms the shit. You know what I mean? What's up, Rick? That was a Cincinnati homie.
All right, little tortilla. Let's see what this motherfucker talking about. Grow a beard like him, me? Fuck no, I got a total bald spot right here. Oh shit.
How you turn this shit up? How you turn this shit up?
You gonna play me something?
Yeah.
What's your name?
I'm Braden.
Brandon?
Braden.
Braden, where you at?
I'm in Kansas right now.
That's it. Of course you are. Hell yeah. Hey, pan around to your boys too. Let me say what's up to all of them.
Hey.
What's up, man? Every mustache is for everybody.
You trying to keep up.
So how do you feel about maybe critiquing something that isn't hip hop?
I would love to.
Hell yeah.
I don't know if you've seen my streams, but I rarely play hip hop, so.
Yeah, hell yeah, cool. So it's like it's like 1 minute.
Perfect, yeah.
Cool.
Or I'll just tell you to stop when I think I get the vibe.
All right. So I'm gonna start it. It's got a long instrumental intro, so.
Yeah, don't do that.
Yeah.
Just give like a 2 second, 3 second.
Cool.
Turn it up. Turn it down. Did you play the guitar or something?
Yeah.
Favorite fucking rock bands from the 70s or 80s, maybe 60s.
Oh man, on the spot, man. Let's see.
That's a dumb question.
Beatles, obviously, I like the Beatles. Their breakthrough. I like listen to.
I heard Hendrix in there.
Yes, Hendrix, Clapton. That's a lot of my guitar playing is in Clapton. Like a minor scale. Mm-hmm. So I that's how I learned guitar was a lot of like Hendrix and Clapton songs.
So I'm not quite sure if it was a connection or whatever, but that was hard to hear too. But I think okay. your voice. I don't know. Did you record it in like a professional studio? Because everything sounded so shitty because the connection is really shitty. But your voice seemed like maybe you did record it in a decent way, and it's got like good reverb or delay on it.
Gotcha. Oh, I was in my bedroom, just through GarageBand.
Shit. All right then. I would just say continue on, man. Fucking that weird instrumental pause for kind of no reason. I don't know if that was an empty spot or whatever.
Cool. Yeah.
I would take that out. Go right into more vocals and shit like that. But you were doing the same melody over and over and over again too. So I'd maybe switch it up for a verse.
Yeah.
Or whatever. You might have that coming in later. But.
Okay.
All right, man. So I'm gonna move on. But fucking what's your name?
Braden.
Braden, yeah, that's right, dude.
Yeah. Hey, thanks, man, so much.
Have fun in Kansas, big dog. Tell all
the hey, will do.
Mustache pimping boys. I say, what's up?
Yeah, will do.
All
right, peace, man.
Man, it's so hard for me to give advice. Like, I can't. I don't know if y'all can hear better than me, but some of this shit, I'm like, it's like, I had a hard time hearing shit. So, not too close to the speakers. Maybe not too far away either. I'm gonna go check in with someone else. Oh shit! What? Oh, I had Jordan Daly on this motherfucker. I was just about to add you, motherfucker, and then you dropped out. Let's go for some more men in the service. This dude looks like he's wearing fatigues too.
Oh shit!
Hey!
This was not expected to happen. What's up?
Just sitting back, relaxing.
I'm just sitting in the car, chilling, watching this. Hello, my name is Earl.
Earl.
Yes. I actually got on stage with you back in Indianapolis quite a while ago. Uh-huh.
You got a mustache too.
Yeah.
Shout out.
Shit.
Do you have music, or are you just wanting to say what's up or whatever?
I was gonna acapella.
Oh shit! Let's go.
Wanted that, too, okay.
Spit at me.
All right, shit. I'm coming at you, and I'm better than ever. I'm like that peanut butter mixed up with Nutella and cheddar. I'm like a Pokemon trainer trying to train a din-a-din and trade it in for a din-a-din and then let's begin. Oh, fuck. Fill me up. I need another couple cups of my double shot Starbucks. Riding shotgun with a pump action shotgun while blasting the soundtrack to Top Gun. That's a little something.
Dude, you're pretty good. Like,
well, here's the thing. So I got on stage with you, and I've always like kind of just fucked around freestyling a little bit, and got on stage with you, and I was like, dude, this is actually really fun because I do stand-up comedy, right?
Okay, all right. So that makes sense because I think you rap really good. Like I said again, like I don't know what your instrument is talking about. Like that sounded to me like it was funny. Like. You do on like comedy on stage, like
yeah,
filling up with the teller. You know what I'm saying? You know, like,
yeah,
it was like a comedic experience. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So for that's why I laughed at the end. Like, yo, that was great. You know, and then I laughed too. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
Obviously, that wasn't like you know like you ain't trying to fucking get signed to Def Jam or anything like that.
No. But So, yeah, so I kind of got into rap, and I actually won my local rap battle tournament recently, and that's been pretty cool. I bought patio furniture with it, but what's good, man? I'm on FaceTime with Prof.
That's one thing about rap battles that are interesting because, like, it doesn't matter if you sound like, you know, like that just sounded hella nerdy and funny to me. But like, if you're in a rap battle and you're saying shit and people laugh and shit, the nerdiest motherfuckers can win or the hoodest motherfuckers can win at any given time. You know what I mean?
But as far as, for sure.
As far as, did you just pick up a belt from that?
Yeah, dude, check this shit out.
Oh,
it was good.
Man, wear it with pride. You know what I mean?
But, it just sits in my room. But you know.
True. So I came up battle rapping, right? And I destroyed a lot of motherfuckers, right? But I also lost too. And everybody who I lost to, I was super angry at, and they never were able to make it or make songs or whatever. You know what I mean? And they're serving me last time. Where was I at? I lost to a battle off of this dude. Anyways, it was a big battle to get to like Scribble Jam back in the day. And he won, and then he was my waiter the other day, and he was like, "Everybody, I just want everybody to know this is Prof, and I beat him, you know, 10 years ago after whatever." And I was like, "All right, man, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's cool. You know, give me my fucking pasta."
Yeah.
All right, man. Good seeing you. All right,
it's good to see you too. Big fan. Keep it real. Can't wait for the new album.
Peace. So yeah, Hilo, or I don't even remember his name. He knows my name. Whoever beat me at that rap battle, Ski. I don't know who it was. Earl was walking around with his championship fucking belt. Walking, what the fuck? Wow. All right, I'm gonna take a caller. Oh, I have no more fucking callers. No one's trying to play me music. I just had like. Wow, this is fucking new. This is kind of embarrassing. I don't know if I can't catch this button. Big flex. Well, now I got different questions coming in. All right. I'm new. This is new, man. How do I get Prof to listen to my song, please and thank you? Well, just stay on, and I was listening to everybody's song. How do I get Prof to hear my shit? That's another question. Same dude. Well, I'm doing it right now. What's your most comfortable writing situation? Fucking right here. So, here, now everybody's blowing me back up to listen to their songs. It is possible. When I picked Earl, there was like 15 motherfuckers. I think that everybody's getting their hopes up. Like, they can't get in. I see them. Can't click them. It's coming. Oh, man, I can't click the button. I feel like fucking, who's that? Who's those old dudes from the R&B battle? Okay. Who can't get their shit to work? View. Fuck. Can't open up the fucking. Yeah, now I got over 10 already. Yeah. Damn, Teddy. Oh my God. I can't click on it. Yeah, Teddy Riley. I forget people's names all the time. So don't blame me. That last question, the most comfortable place to do my shit? Right up in here, man. Right up in here. I'm very lucky. It's not like the most fancy shit, but I definitely don't need any more. Oh, see, well, this works. So these buttons are working for me. But my other ones. I'm double tapping on them and they're not coming in. P. Dunn, Channel Gompo, Wyatt DD, all those motherfuckers. I'm trying to get you on, but I just can't. Damn, bro. Damn. Yo, nothing. Don't trust nobody sending you selfies with filters. That's all I gotta say. Man, I might log off and log back on for 10 minutes, see if that works. I'm gonna do that right now because I made this stream specifically to get at people and to hear their shit, and it's not letting me press this button. It's saying that I'm pressing it, like I'm pushing it and it's changing colors and shit, but it's not bringing it up. You ever update the effects on music videos? Was that just high? No, I don't update music videos. You're just high. And I'm gonna do an extra 20 minutes. If it works, I'll do an extra 20 minutes of listening to people's shit just to make it up to y'all. I'm gonna end this and start again. And I'm back, bitch. And I'm back, bitch. And I'm back, bitch. Damn, these iPads, man. Oh, look at this. People are coming here. We're back. Right? Like nothing fucking happened. What up, my shit? We go. Like nothing ever fucking happened. Don't pay attention.
Hey, what up?
Hey!
My dude. What's the word, bro?
How's your quarantine?
You see it, bro. Just chilling in the studio. Same shit as you.
You essential or are you unemployed? What's popping?
I'm fucking chilling in the studio, bro. Same
shit. So you unemployed?
Yo. Still working, though. Still working, though.
Same with me.
So, yeah, I'm about to play you a song. It's not finished. It's unmixed, but I'm about to throw it at you, bro.
Where are you from?
I'm from Detroit.
What's your name?
Stan. They call me Machete, though. All
right. I like Stan.
Yeah, should I turn it up or turn it down? Let me know.
All right. Okay, all right.
Fuck with that?
No. There's a lot wrong with that.
What you like? What you don't like about it?
I'm just playing. No, that was good, man. It's very brand new. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, I try to be different, man. I try to incorporate a lot of like my little emo vibes from when I was a teenager. Shit like that, but I still fuck with the
emo
rap
vibes,
and stuff.
XX, you know, XXX in the, up in there, like.
Yeah, the beat got a little club vibe to it.
Oh yeah, you know who Monson is?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it reminds me of that kind of shit.
Yeah. I'm glad you fucked with that a little bit, man.
Yeah. You know.
Was I using my shit like an instrument?
Yeah, absolutely, man. Yeah. It's like yeah, like Lil Peep. You fuck with like Lil Xan and all them and shit.
Yeah, I know about that. Really, I don't listen to it, man. Like I said, really, I listen to a lot of like fucking alternative emo music, shit like that. Some of my favorite rappers are like Intuition. If you know Intuition, that's like my number one favorite rapper, bro.
Okay.
You, I listen to you a lot. I listen to a lot of Greaves, Atmosphere. That's like what I came up off on my rap shit. But I'm just trying to incorporate that new style that people like.
You know, there's not much I can say about it. That's actually pretty good, man.
Hell yeah, man. If you ever are playing shows again after this quarantine, you come to Detroit, you need some openers, you let me know, bro.
Bro, Stan, a.k.a. What?
Machete.
Machete. I like Stan. Stan, to me, cause you know the connotation of it now is like, you're a Stan, you're a fan. Like, to me, like, Stan sounds like dangerous. Like, yeah, I'm a Stan. I'll be outside your fucking crib at 4 a.m, bitch.
Right,
yes,
right.
Stan. Like, you might want to think about having that be your rap name, Tame, too, because that shit is, like, super catchy to me, like, Stan. Like,
just
this dude's gully. He's a little creepy. He's a little creeper. Little creeper Stan. Little creeper Stan sounds fucking dope, but good shit, man. Good.
Thanks
good
a lot, bro.
No doubt.
Yeah, you have a good one.
Peace. That wasn't bad. What y'all think of that? I'm bad. I like Stan too. Shit. All right, who's up next? Chanel Gompo. Let's see what this is all about. Little Stan. Creeper Stan.
Hi.
Ooh, what's up?
Oh, not much. I got my flower crown on. I made it.
You're done hard.
Oh, thank you. Gosh, wow. You look all right.
Damn. I'm ashamed to be in the same, sharing the same computer screen with you.
Oh, it's just my phone. It's okay. My screen's cracked. Maybe yours isn't too, but.
Okay, what's going on? Where are you from?
Georgia, but I live in Denver.
Okay.
Yeah. And I just more of have like spoken word. Is that cool?
Yeah, hit me.
Okay. I'm all nervous now.
Yeah, take a deep breath and just relax. You're only talking to a phone screen.
I'm talking to like my favorite person. You shut up. Oh, okay. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right. My mild insomniac giving me heart attacks, and I see your name on my phone 2-3 times a night. At 2, 3, 5 in the morning, I can't help but wonder what you think about, how far your mind wanders when you let it out, and does it come back before the sun can make its rounds, washing away the black? I hate to say this, but you look tired, hun. I'd ask if you slept, but I know you've had none in some days, and it must be like years in a daze.
Slow down.
Okay.
Put intentions into every word. Keep going.
It must be tiring sitting around waiting for life to take you down even for a couple of hours before your morning shower. Cause it feels like you've always got to do more. That's all I've got. But
okay, so your writing was really good. You got nervous, fed your way through it. You know what I mean?
I got super nervous.
Yeah, so it's like I couldn't even enjoy it. I knew it was good, but take your time and force it. Force feed me. Put it in my face and be proud of every single word.
Okay, can I start again?
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna start over with the same one, I guess.
Please.
All right. My mild insomniac giving me heart attacks, and I see your name on my phone 2-3 times a night at 2-3-5 in the morning. I can't help but wonder what you think about, how far your mind wanders when you let it out, and does it come back where the sun can make its rounds, washing away the black? I hate to say this, but you look tired, hun. I'd ask if you slept, but I know you've had none in some days, and it must feel like years in a daze in so many ways. It must be so tiring sitting around waiting for life to take you down even for a couple of hours before your morning shower. It feels like you've always got to do more.
Okay. So you like, you still sped through it. For me, it feels like you don't think you're important enough to take up everybody's time.
Oh.
Demand that time, right? So I hate to say this, but you look tired, son. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the morning. So you know, now you're kind of getting into like the acting realm a little bit, but it's still communication and shit. And I think your delivery can get a lot better. Just confidence and demand everybody's time.
Yeah.
And this is when you have my time, there's nothing else that's more important to me in the entire world than this last 30 seconds. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And you have my full attention. This is important. And just take me by the balls and fucking drag me kicking and screaming down your hallway. This is your time. Hell wow. Yeah.
Well, hopefully you liked it. I mean,
I did.
I write a lot. And I know your lyrics are so creative. I'm always like, damn, how can I get on that level?
Honestly, this might sound weird, but practice your shit in front of a mirror and talk to yourself. And get weird. And take your time and go into weird fucking levels and weird zones. And don't feel any type of way. And just dive off that fucking bridge.
Absolutely. Wow, I'm like so happy that you at least like listened. Oh my God, I do that. We fucking, yeah. Oh my God.
All right then.
But I can't wait for you to come back to Denver. I have big plans to win your heart, so.
All right, I can't wait to get back to Denver. I had plans already. So it'll be a while till I can tour again, but I'll see you again.
Absolutely, thank you so much.
All right, good shit. That was interesting, right? That was pretty interesting. Oh, shit. Prof, me next. All right, who's next? This dude's been sitting number one on my... Wait, oh, he just fell off. All right, Fee the BB, Phoebe. You come, Phoebe. Here you go,
baby. Oh my God.
Hey.
Oh my God, you're my favorite hip hop artist ever.
What's going on?
This is crazy. I'm the girl in Portland that gave you a sticker and you let me put it on your belly. At the concert in Portland, Maine.
What year?
It was a little it was last year on Halloween. Or 2019. In Portland,
2019 Maine. Halloween.
Yeah.
Wait, so I was there. I don't know. Fucking, what venue was that called?
That was at, I'm so nervous right now. That was at a State Theater? Or no, Port City.
I don't know. It was cracking, right? It was like sold out?
It was amazing. Yeah, that was a really good
show. I don't remember shit, man.
It was a little like gnome sticker, and he was holding a mushroom.
You're breaking up. I can't see you anymore, but
I don't know.
Damn, okay, I think we lost her. Yo, I have a lot of memories, y'all. And I do a lot of things in a lot of places. So someone put a fucking sticker on me someplace, man, you know.
No fucking way.
What?
Holy shit. Hi, Prof.
what's happening?
I was playing Xbox.
Really?
Yeah, holy shit.
What were you playing?
Apex Legends.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck that is, but hope it's fun.
Yeah, I actually sing. I play guitar. I sing country music.
Can you sing and play guitar at the same time right now?
No.
Uh-uh.
No.
What are you going to do? Just sing, or are you going to play the guitar?
Fuck, I'll sing for you.
Okay.
But I sing country, so.
Let's go.
Here we go. Well, I like my loving in country style. And this little girl will walk a country mile to find her a good old slow talk country boy. I said a country boy.
That's not bad.
Oh, I'm shaking. I'm so happy.
I know you sounded like the hardest thing to do, and I've had to do it a million times in my life, like, right? So like, so there's been times I was like live on ESPN during X Games and shit. And I came out during like the half pipe session and shit. And they're like, ladies and gentlemen, Prof. And I was like waiting backstage. I had my ear things on. I'm like, and this happened a million times to me. The hardest fucking thing to do is to sing while you're amped up and nervous. It's the hardest fucking thing in the entire world. So what you got to do is, I don't know, man. I have a lot of experience doing it, but if you know, you got to take a deep breath and I don't know. Try and calm down, I guess. It's really hard to sing, especially solid notes when you're nervous and your blood's pumping.
Well, I actually grew up in church, you know, singing church, and I grew up in a bluegrass family. My grandfather was on the Grand Ole Opry doing bluegrass music.
So where are you from, Maine?
Kentucky.
Kentucky. Are you there right now?
No, I'm actually in Florida.
Okay.
I was in Minnesota there for a while. I was dating your boy, Mike Robinson, and that didn't go out right.
I don't know who that is.
He's a really tall ass motherfucker.
He might have stories about
from like way back in the day, probably. He's like 6'9", freaky ass looking.
See, that might have been lies too. Like I don't know who Mike Robinson is.
Now, anyways, I was supposed to be in your video, Cousins, but I didn't make it. Yeah, I was supposed to be there, but
all right, well, good singing, you're not bad. Love you. Keep it trail.
Thanks. I had a screech.
All right, so I'm gonna do like another 10 minutes or whatever. There's the funny thing is, like, I like to keep my private life private because there's so many lies that go around about me. I'm their boy. Every single show, if I talk to somebody, oh yeah, you're Mike Campbell, this dude's boy, and this guy, and I'm like, oh, never met him. There's been rumors that I've done crazy coke binges and fucking did crack and shit. I'm like, I don't do crack. I've never been there. So, yeah, he's the tall dude. Here we go. Who's up next? This dude's been, oh, there you go. He's back. He's been on the front of the line for a long time. WYDLDLDLYDL.
Oh shit!
Oh shit! Oh shit!
It's the beat guy again. Oh no! I'm not gonna do a beat rhyme.
Oh no, it's you!
I'm not gonna do a beat rhyme this time. But y'all,
wait! I'm so happy you're back. Look! You had me thinking for like fucking 3 days. I thought about you, dog.
That's all I'm trying to do. Probably not why you wanted to think about me though.
No, but I was like, man, you know, a lot of people, I get off the computer screen and shit, and I'm like, man. There's other things that pop into my head about other critique I could have gave him or other things I could have said that I didn't say at the time.
That's cool. No worries.
One thing I wanted to tell you was if bees are your main fucking shit, right?
They're not.
Wow.
I'm just saying, they're not my main fucking shit. I own a sensory deprivation and float tank wellness center, and I'm just in quarantine right now, so I'm fucking just writing poetry and shit like that while I'm sitting around and don't have my normal job. I also am a CBD producer extractor as well, weightless hemp extract. I'm also living in Kentucky, Louisville, but I got a song that I just wrote. Buddy of mine sent me a beat, just dude I connected with. He was like, yo man, I haven't seen you in a while. I made this song given everything that's going on right now, and he sent it to me. The title was called Sign of the Times, and I was like, all right, what's a sign of the times? Literally, I was thinking about like road signs, and I thought about like what would be a road sign of the times right now. Probably like the right lane's ending, merge left. And that's kind of what I took the direction of the song with.
Whoa, 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 whoa. So that line, the right lane is ending, merge left. To me, that's an incredible metaphor of like, you can't leave, motherfucker. We're all in this together.
Yeah, and we're merging into the, well, mainly like we're merging into the, you know, when you're like, yo, everyone's passing, get out of the left lane. Or when you're like, yo, you got to merge over because the right lane's ending. It's kind of like we're merging or being forced to merge into a different lane as we're like getting on a. And literally, this was just because he sent me the song called Sign of the Times. And I was like, all right, literally, what would be
Sign of the Times? Play me a minute. Play me a minute of it.
All right. Let me know if you can hear me, too, even if you can't. Because last time I noticed, it just sounded like me yelling at the camera.
Yeah.
You couldn't really hear the beat. So it starts with a little hook here. It goes. Riding up the on-ramp, reading the sign. It says merge left. The right lane ends. Riding up the on-ramp, reading the sign. Says merge left, the right lane ends. Hit the pedal like a hammer to the firing pin. Barreling down the cold stairs of a seven-headed Leviathan. Blasphemy, that by action seems to me to have reached max capacity. Been in the backseat, writing this rap sheet. Collecting data for decades by how we trapped heat. Nobody asked me, people most savvy. So while these rats eat, don't even at me. The back of workers serving corporations like a taxi. Money burning holes and regulations at the max. Stacking power, lust, and greed. Party like Jay Gatsby. Till these attacks cease, don't even at me. Riding up the on-ramp, reading the sign. It says merge left, the right lane ends. Riding up the on-ramp, reading the sign. It says merge left, the right lane ends. Thicker than the system that we use in the tree. Faker than the food.
Okay, I got it. Okay.
Nah, okay, straight. Okay, the only thing...
The sound of this is the best sounding call in there's been. So,
nice.
How far away is your phone from the speakers and shit? You gotta go on down. You gotta go on.
Nah, bro, I really don't. I got my phone. I got my laptop open with my iTunes playing the beat homie just sent me. I got a book sitting on my laptop, and I just got my phone leaned up against it, and I just
You play that out your laptop?
Well, I got like my laptop here. A speaker here and another one sitting down right there. I mean, it's all
okay. Good. So you're kind of far away from your speaker, which is, I think, a good thing. And the speakers are loud.
I'm maybe like 2 feet.
All right, listen to me. Listen. The only thing I can say is, I don't know what your main goal of making music is. Like, if you want to be world famous, or if you just want to get your message across, or if this is a hobby of yours. You know what I mean?
My goal basically has always been, like, I'm from Rhode Island, actually. Sage Francis and B. Dolan came to my high school and blew my fucking mind with slam poetry, and I got really into doing that. And then I just, like, lived all over the place. I, like, went on festival tour a bunch when I was younger, but I always just freestyled and rapped and shit like that. And I always have had businesses and made my own businesses, and I'm always like, yeah, once I get the plate spinning, I'm gonna, like, put it aside, let someone else hold it, and then I'm gonna make music. And right now, since I'm just... sitting around, I'm kind of sifting for nuggets of gold in my old notebooks and shit like that. Right.
To me, it's like, bro, you can't sit still.
No, I can't totally.
So, I mean, okay, so a lot of your music shit is like really, the B shit was really specific. This is a little bit less specific.
It's literally just what I'm writing right now. Sorry.
The only really specific critique I could have for that song is it's pretty good and it sounded decent. Something merged right. What was that line?
Which one?
The merge right.
Oh, the riding up the on ramp, reading the sign. It says merge left. The right lane ends.
Okay, the right lane ends. That you should sing that, or have some people come in there and sing that, or something like that.
All right.
You need to get out of your head on that and make it a little bit more melodic and shit like that. But you're an interesting character, and I love you.
Word, brother, man. Yo, if you ever come to Louisville again, come through and float before a show. I love hosting artists come through, get in the sensory deprivation tank, sit in the sauna, get a massage.
Dude, I went into a sensory deprivation tank once in my life, right? And at the time, I was working on like 10 paintings.
Mm.
And I floated in this fucking tank, and I went way too long. I went 90 minutes, and I started to flip out. I had to get
Yeah, we only offer 90 minutes or longer.
Oh, fuck that.
I mean, you can get out whenever you want to, but, yo, you take an edible get in the tank or, like, even chomp some psychedelics to get in there? It is.
Yo. So this is what happened. I got the tank, and all of a sudden, I couldn't see shit or whatever, blah, blah, blah. And my mind, turn off your music because it's getting distracting.
Oh, my bad.
I gotta go back to the tank. My mind went all the way out to outer space, and I took the most detailed trip out of the Earth, and I was floating around the outer space looking at the Earth and shit like that. And then I saw every single one of my paintings that I was working on. I was working on 10 at the exact same time, and they all had problems where I stopped, and you know, I stop and I think about them. I was able to visualize all the layers, all the colors on every single painting, figure out what was wrong and what I wanted to do next, and then title that painting and move on to the next painting. I went through 10 paintings like bro. Right now, like when I'm in the real world and I can touch and feel and see things, I can't even think about three of those paintings. At that time, my mind was so fucking fucked up and crazy because it was all alone and expanded like nuts. That was the only experience I had with the sensory deprivation tank, and I want to go back.
It gets better. It's just same with like playing an instrument or meditating or going to the gym. You do it one time, it has an effect on you. You might feel it, but not like when you do it consistently and you get practice with it. Because like you can approach the float for anything, whether you come straight from a workout, you get that detox of like lactic acid, you get no gravity on your body, you get all the benefits of the Epsom salt. But when you get in the tank and you close every app on your brain, you kind of reallocate all that bandwidth, and you can either meditate in that space, you can think in that space, you can just totally, I'd say check out.
I started to think, and then it was like, because it's taking away all of your sense, it's taking away your body, so it's all it is you're in your head, and I got, after, I went through a bunch of incredible shit, and then I got so claustrophobic that I panicked, and I had to get the fuck out of there, so, but I'm going to try it again.
Yeah, dude, yo, come through sometime, man. There's a lot of great benefits to doing it. I highly, too, encourage if you're in a legal decriminalized state with cannabis or like psilocybin or anything like that, hop in one of those experiences, because it is the safest place to actually have a psychedelic experience, because you don't have all these other potentials for things to go wrong, like to get cold, you know, don't know somebody, you hear a song that freaks you out, like in there it's love.
Wow. All right, then, appreciate you. That's dope to think about.
Appreciate you, dude. Thank you.
Peace.
Stay safe.
All right, so who knew on Prof's Creative Academy? That's some creative ass shit. Sensory deprivation tanks, if you don't know, before I sign off, I'll just explain this, is you sit in this weird ass pod, you open it up, big tank, you lay down, the water is perfect, 98.6 degrees or whatever the fuck your body's at, and it's filled with salt water, so you float with no effort, right? And so, and then they close the fucking tank on you. And then it's 100% pitch black dark. So then while you're floating in this salt water that takes all your body completely away, you can't see shit, your sight is completely gone, your sense of smell kind of like dissolves away once you start to get used to that. And then it's fucking on. Then it's some crazy shit. So, I've only done it once, like I just talked about with my bro right there, but I'm going to have to do it again. He reminded me. Take a fucking mushroom, smoke some weed, eat an edible, get an edible. All right. Peace, y'all. Appreciate y'all. Next time.